afternoon, friends. My name is Kip Coerper. I'm a choir master organist here at St. James Church in Skaneateles, New York. I'm wearing my vestments today because it's possible we will use the recording of one or two of these pieces in our Sunday morning worship. They are planned to be played on Sunday at 9 when we will have a traditional music service that will be recorded on Facebook so you can watch anytime. That is typical for our Sunday morning schedule. On next Wednesday is Ash Wednesday, the beginning of Lent. So my program will be very different in nature to reflect the solemnity of that occasion. We will also have a live streamed worship at 7 a.m. on Ash Wednesday, midday music at 12:10, and then another service from the rectory at 6 Wednesday night on Ash Wednesday. Today's music is going to speak of glory. This coming Sunday is Alleluia Sunday. It's the last Sunday of Epiphany before we start the solemn season of Lent. And so typically we sing lots of Alleluias, which we will be singing in our hymns on Sunday. And I just wanted to read a little bit of the scripture because the glory that is spoken in this scripture is what I'm trying to depict in the glorious music that I had to share with you today. From the Gospel of Mark, the story is the Transfiguration, when Christ was on the mountaintop with his disciples Peter, James, and John. And he was transfigured before them, and his clothes became dazzling white, such as no one on earth could bleach them. And the second verse of our middle hymn, with shining face and bright array, Christ deigns to manifest today. What glory shall be theirs above, who joy in God with perfect love. So I hope to share with you some joy and glory in the music I've chosen. The first piece is a arrangement of Ye Watchers and Ye Holy Ones, which will be the final hymn on Sunday. It's hymn 618 in our hymnal. And it's written by my first organ professor in college, Richard T. Gore. It's a fascinating piece because it's a double fugue. So the left hand imitates the right hand, a measure apart, and in the pedal, the left foot imitates the right foot. So there are two rounds going on at the same time and lots of glory, and you'll hear the melody in the pedal.
Thank you.
pieces are written by Healy Whelan, the great Canadian organist choir director, and short arrangements of hymns. The first one is Saint Anne, which is O God, Our Help in Ages Past, attributed to William Croft, who lived in the 1700s. And we believe he was inspired by the name of this tune because it was a church where he served as organist, St. Anne's Church in England. Set to different tunes, but these two have stayed together for since that time.
Thank you.
one setting of hymns. He has written some wonderful arrangements. We're going to finish today with a prelude fugue by Bach. These pieces tend to be larger, and so they take more time to practice, and that's why you don't hear them very often from me. But this is the prelude and fugue in C major. He wrote several in C major, so if you're an organ scholar, you'll know that there are others. But this one has lots of energy, and again, speaks of the glory, I believe, especially at the beginning, that we're trying to depict on Alleluia, for Alleluia Sunday this coming Sunday.
Thank you.
enjoyed the glory of some great organ music on this wonderful instrument that we have here. And most three of those pieces you'll hear again Sunday morning at 9 if you are interested. Remember, it's Alleluia Sunday. The sun was shining when I started, but I don't know if it still is. But enjoy this glorious day and have a blessings on your week.